What is good, everybody? So gamer back again. We are doing yet another tutorial, another install. We got, so frankly, he's got his dealership. He's been moving a lot of cars, but he has the big car transporter. Sometimes he just needs to move one or two cars. And with these exotic cars, you don't want to put mileage on them. So you don't want to drive them from point to point. So we're going to install the Gooseneck trailer with the Ram 3500. Now, I have seen a lot of videos on this. What I haven't seen is there's not many videos, and I'm not saying that they're not out there, but there's not many videos on how to use this thing. So we're gonna go ahead and install it. I'm gonna mess around with it and see if we can't learn how to better use this, because I just see a lot of videos on people playing with it and not actually how to use it. All right, so we'll get started on that. I'll link the RAM in the description, and then we'll jump into GTA once we have it installed and figure out what to do with it. So this has been out for a few years. There's been a few updates. Let's see. I did look through the comments before, but I didn't, nothing caught my eye as to how to actually make it function. Such as, and what I mean by that is like for example, the big car carrier, there's a mod, and maybe I'll do a video on that mod as well, but where you actually can attach the vehicles to the trailer. You can lower the ramp and everything along those lines. And I see people doing it with this particular mod, but none of those videos explain how to do it. So let's just jump in, Let's just download it. Also, the truck is really dope on this one. I have had it. I had it installed for a little bit, but I was messing around with a bunch of different flatbed trailers and things like that, so I didn't really get to use it and explore how to use it. So let's see. So we have an add-on and a replace info, essentially the README text for it. It looks like it gives us. First, if we want to replace the vehicle, the truck, I'm assuming, I believe the Bison is a truck. I'm not going to go for the replacement. I think I'm just going to do the add-on. So let's do the README for the add-on. Ramp J. Yeah, so basically we have to add the truck and the trailer, and that will do it for us. So we'll start out by going into the GTA5 directory, then we'll go to mods, update x64. And DLC packs and add Ramp J. You know what? Where's the truck? Oh, so it looks like they both should be included with Ramp J. Okay. But when we go to spawn them, these are the names that we're looking for. Cool. So We got it moved over to our DLC packs folder. Now we need to launch OpenIV. Waiting for that. Let me take a quick look at my messages. Helping a friend out with her computer that's broken. I do. I'm an IT tech. I would say in my spare time, but this is actually my spare time doing this. And so that's what I do for a living as my profession. Hopefully, soon, if everything goes well, I'll be able to switch that around and do this as my profession and do IT in the meantime or in my spare time to make some extra money. It's not imperative, so I'll wait to handle that after the video. All right, so we got the OpenIV open. Let's go to mods, update, update.rpf, common data. Again, double check, make sure edit mode is turned on. Scroll down to DLC list and left click one time to highlight it. Then right click and select edit. And scroll all the way down to the bottom of the list. Left click one time on the last line. Then right click and select duplicate current line. And we're going to delete what's between the slashes and type in ramp J. And then save that. Okay, no error messages, so it saved for us. And as long as we have everything spelled properly, then we should be good to go. So we're going to be looking for these two vehicles in our added vehicles menu once we launch GTA5. So let's get in there and mess around with this trailer, see if we can get it to work. More importantly, how to get it to work. All right. What a day, what a day. Alright, y'all. So, let's go ahead and find a spot. Yo, Franklin's elbows are ashy, bro. Let's go ahead and find a spot. We will spawn the truck and the trailer. Actually, might already have the truck spawned if it's still in the same spot I left it. And, we'll go through how to attach the vehicle. At least how I found how to do it. This may not be the proper way. There may be another way to do it. Oh man. But this is the best way that I found it. Listen to that Challenger Charger. Alright, let's head out. I think Franklin might need some energy. Whoa. So he's probably gonna have to slam an energy drink or two before we attach the vehicle to the trailer. Hope the tutorial of installing it helped. Again, it's basically. It's actually pretty cool because it's one file, one add-on file. You get two vehicles. So, let's see if they're spawned, if they are spawned. We'll still walk through the process of spawning the vehicle. Okay, so the truck is spawned. What's the other car? Oh, the other car is the Novatek Ferrari. Okay. Dope. So, let's do this here. We'll leave the truck there. So that's the 350. If you need to spawn it, and you're not familiar with how to spawn vehicles, I personally like to use Simple Trainer. And you can spawn
So you gotta press RB on the controller to bring up Simple Trainer. You have to press RB and X at the same time. Of course, RB is the button on the controller that causes you to hide behind a wall. So, so I press RB, or you could press F3 on your keyboard. I guess I've never really specified. Hopefully, people could tell just by how I always talk. But I use a PC. I play GTA and my GTA on a PC. So, in case there is any question regarding that. Anyway, so we got
Here if
Simple
you
Trainer
promise,
spawned.
Dino. If you have any real shoes, you'll be
This is
fine.
why I like it. As I mentioned before, you can just scroll down to added vehicles and it brings up your
Right,
added
before you
vehicle menu.
asshole. Like I said,
To
you
spawn the
deserve
truck,
better.
yo, these people are loud. To spawn the truck,
You can take a shot like the rest of us.
it's called 10 RAM. So it's for my list, it's the very first option. Probably will be on most since it starts with a number. But I already got the truck spawned, so let's go through. We gotta find the trailer. The trailer is called PJ Trailer. And there it is at the very end of my list. Look at that. I got 125 add-on vehicles installed. It didn't even seem like that many. Alright, so we got the trailer. Now, this is what I like. When you spawn the trailer, it sits Franklin up at the front, or whoever you're playing with. It sits them up at the front, like they're driving the trailer. Now, when you're sitting in the front like this, you can actually lower the ramp. If you bring up menu, bring up menu. Oh, I didn't have it launched. You can lower it by going to vehicle options and then menu customs, and then go to doors, and those are essentially the trunk. So scroll down to trunk, and boom, it lays out the ramp. So that's if you're sitting in the trailer. Now, if you're not in the trailer, you could still do that, but what you'll need to do is go into spinner mode, and you can do that by pressing F9 on your keyboard or RB and right D-pad. Point it at the trailer and then press the right trigger on your controller. And then scroll down to menu customs. And the same thing, go to doors. Now, to close it though, you can't go to trunk. You have to go to all. So if you click trunk, it will open it. But if you click trunk again, it will not close it. You have to select all to close it. Alright. So that's how you get the ramp down. Now, before we load a vehicle up on here, I'm going to go ahead and get this out of the way before we cause a major accident. Because people are unruly around here. Oh, what happened? There was a bunch of people at the barbecue spot just a second ago. Must have been happy hour. Alright. Now, to attach the trailer to the truck, it's actually really simple. All you gotta do is back the truck up under the gooseneck, and it automatically connects. Now, this trailer is pretty long. I didn't realize. I thought this is like a single vehicle trailer at first. I had it installed a long time ago, but never really used it, so I never really got an idea of how long it was. Okay, this car needs to move off. You know what? We'll just pull up over here. Sometimes when you have a trailer, you just have to admit or accept the fact that you're not gonna get it everywhere that you wanna go. So we're just gonna find the simplest location to park it. Seems like right here is a good spot. So we can load a vehicle up on it. Pull up a little bit. Throw on those hazards. I forgot how to turn on the hazard lights. Think there's a way through the menu. Let's make it official, y'all. Let's turn on those hazard lights. Oh, you know what? I know Simple Trainer has it for sure. But vehicle options. Vehicle lights menu. Hazard lights. Alright. We official now. We got the hazard lights on. So, there's something I want to point out. So, I'm going to go into spooner mode really quick. Let's lower the ramp. Bam. There we go. So, we lower that ramp. Oh, Franklin died? Oh, damn! Yo, Franklin is really dying. Let's get some energy in his system. I completely forgot. I said it before we even left the house that he's gonna need energy. And then I didn't even have a freaking energy drinks. By the way, I do not recommend slamming energy drinks back to back like that. It's probably very dangerous. Okay, so let's jump in the Rari. It's 488 over tech. I think it is. I'm not sure if it kind of looks like it has a kit on it. Yeah. Yeah, it does. You have an Overtech kit on. Yo, did I not lock the trailer? Bro. Wow. So concerned about the Overtech kit on this Ferrari that I did not lock the trailer. And it disappeared on me. Anyways, this Overtech kit is dope. This Novatech Ferrari is dope. Oh man, let's spawn these real quick again. That's good right there. Lock it. There we go. Okay, so let's get back to what I was trying to explain. I'm gonna go back to the screen mode. We're gonna go with the ramp. Doors. Trunk. Bam. Now, while we're in spinner mode, I just want to point something out. In order to be able to add this vehicle, or any vehicle, to the ramp, from what I found, is we need to add the entity to the database. So that's this option right here, the very second option. It says entity is in database. We're going to need to put a check in that box. I'm going to uncheck it for a moment, just so I can show you. So if we don't have it added to the database, I've seen it before where the trailer does come up, but it typically does not. So if we want to add the car, now you don't have to actually drive it up onto the ramp. I just want to do it for the realistic effect. So what we want to do to add the vehicle to the ramp. Did he just say what I think he said? I'm sorry, I'm getting distracted. Okay. So, what we'll want to do is go back into spoon mode and point it at the vehicle with the right trigger, go to attachment options, and attach to something. Now, notice we don't have the trailer as an option to attach to. That's because it's not added as. The entity isn't added to the database. Okay. So, let's try that again. Again, driving up on the trailer isn't necessary. But, so let's go back into spooner mode, point it at the trailer, press the right trigger, and then select entity is in database. Then exit spooner mode, I'm gonna drive the car back up on the trailer. We're gonna go back into spooner mode. And it's because I have simple fuel installed that also uses F9, that's why that other menu keeps on coming up, so don't trip out if you're not seeing that. If you don't have simple fuel, it's not needed for this, it's a different mod. Okay, so we're gonna point at the vehicle, press right trigger, go back to attachment options, attach to something, and now we have PJ trailer as an option. So we just click on that, and there we go. The vehicle is now attached to the trailer and will not go anywhere. Now, that being said, one thing that I have noticed is some vehicles sit like this on the trailer. Halfway down on the trailer. So, I'm not 100% sure how to fix that. If that is just with certain cars or... you know what? Let's try this. I wonder if we can position. Okay, well, maybe I'll mess with that a little more and do a bit more research, see if there's a way to fix that. But ultimately, that is how you attach the vehicle to the trailer. Now, if you want to close that ramp, go ahead and go back into spinning mode. Right trigger pointing at the trailer. Go back to menu customs. Doors, and we again go to all instead of trunk, because trunk will not close it for some reason. Exit menu or exit spoon mode. Sometimes I think I'm like a living, breathing stereotype. You ain't kidding. There we go. So, hope this helped. I am going to look more into the placement of the vehicle, because I have seen it where the vehicles actually sit on top of the ramp. I'm not sure if maybe it's just this vehicle. This is an add-on vehicle. So potentially, you know, there may be certain vehicles that just sit different because, you know, they're add-on vehicles. So, you know, maybe I'll try it with the vehicle that comes on the game. Either way, I hope this helped. I appreciate y'all watching. Please like the video and subscribe. Be a big help. I want to hit 1,000 subscribers. I can do that. I will definitely be doing some giveaways. Not exactly sure what yet, but I know some people have expressed interest in the Soul Searching hoodie that I wear sometimes, as well as the sneakerhead t-shirts. Those are part of a lifestyle brand that I am designing. They're not for sale anymore, and I haven't decided exactly when or if I'm going to proceed on with selling them. But I will definitely give you guys more information regarding the Soul Searching brand in future videos. So maybe I'll do some giveaways with that, but I definitely will have some giveaways for my first 1,000 followers or subscribers once we hit that landmark. So I greatly appreciate it. Turn on those notifications, that way you get notified on my latest videos, and I will catch y'all in the next video. Until then, peace.